Well, howdy everybody, it's Chris again, and today what I want to do is just make a quick video of my camera bag. You see, a few people have been asking me what kind of stuff I keep and what kind of equipment I use, and the answer is going to be here. I know lots of these camera bag videos are just super popular on the internet, so I thought I'd show you a few of my things, and the guinea pig. Now, let's see, here's my camera. Well, that's my bag. Just a really nice sort of... It wasn't too expensive, actually. My housemate gave it to me as a birthday present. Yeah, it was pretty cheap. And there's my address in Korean and English. I'm currently living in Korea. And all this camera equipment is much, much cheaper than it is back in the UK. So I've gone a bit overboard and gotten loads and loads of camera stuff. Here is my camera, of course. As you might know, a Canon 60D. You might be familiar to you from the review. Let's turn it on and see what's going on. Yeah, of course. What's that? No card in camera. Oops. Oh, well, whatever. There's the articulating screen. And yes, there we go. Filming the guinea pig. Excellent. Yes, it's just a... Well, if you want to know more about that, I've made a review of that camera, really. It's wonderful. It makes me very happy. I love that camera. It's just great. And here we go. On the front, I have... Now, this lens, I love this lens. I decided, for a long time, I was using a super zoom lens. Here we are. This is my super zoom lens. I've just made a review on it for my channel. It's a Tamron 18 to 270mm VC lens, so it's a really good super zoom lens. For a super zoom lens, it's good. As you can tell from my review, if you watch my review, you'll see what I think of it. But I don't know, I wasn't too happy with the quality because I want really amazing quality and for more of my pictures and or for more of my filmmaking. And also I wanted something with a faster aperture because of all the filmmaking I do. I really like low light filmmaking. Yeah, so I decided to go for this instead. It's a 17 to 55mm fast standard zoom f2.8. So it lets in lots of light. I've made a review of this as well, actually. It lets in lots of light. And also, oh, what's he doing? Isn't that cute? Well, I found myself, when I was using the Tamron lens, I found myself not really using the extreme focal lengths very often. I just found myself using that standard sort of focal length, like 17 to 50 millimeter. I found myself using that all the time. So I thought, oh yeah, I might as well. This has a smaller focal range and a zoom, super zoom lens, but, you know, it's much, much nicer quality and it'll make me happy, so. Yeah, and I never looked back, actually. I've used this lens. This lens just stays on my camera all the time. It's just fantastic quality. It's really, really fast. It's the bread and butter sort of wedding photographer lens because it is so fast. It's got, yeah, image stabilization. Everything I need is on there. I use it all the time. And this is the kind of lens I really recommend to people to use. People ask me, you know, what kind of zoom lens should I get if I want to do filmmaking? Something like this. It's really expensive though, so Tamron do an equivalent one, which is 17 to 50 millimeter, and it's much cheaper. It doesn't have quite such nice quality, but yeah, the Tamron one is what I recommend most to people who want a really nice lens for filming, but who don't want to spend too much money. Oh, yes, there we go. This lens is expensive, but it is fantastic. And look at that giant lens hood. It's absolutely huge. Makes it look nice and professional, which impresses my friends and anyway, any other people, in case you actually have a friend. Like I said, here's my Tamron lens. I just did a review of it, so, you know, there's not much more I want to say about it. I'm not using it at all at the moment. I just don't find myself doing telephoto pictures or telephoto work, certainly not for film work anyway. So yeah, I'm actually going to sell this lens, even though it's very good. I just don't feel the need for a super zoom lens. I really love having, you know, super high picture quality in my pictures, and super zoom lenses aren't ideal for that, but they are, of course, they are very super convenient. Let's see, what's over here? A few people ask me if I want to make reviews of microphones. Like, I don't actually know. My dad is sort of a sound... Well, he has been a sound engineer before, so I know my way around sound equipment, but yeah, this is the only microphone I have or have experience with. It's a Sennheiser, oh gosh, can I see? All you can see is made in Germany. Sennheiser MKE400 directional microphone. Really, really useful to have one of these. Let's see. I'm holding a camera with one hand. Maybe I can get this off. This furry thing cost extra. But it reduces wind noise quite a lot, actually. I'm really glad I got it. And there you go. There's the microphone. It captures sound in one direction only. Well, not only, but yeah, it does a very good job. I'm really glad I have that. Yeah, it's very useful. It's great for sound, actually. Here we go. Here's another lens. This is my 50mm, can we see? Yeah, there we go. 50mm f1.4. This is the first lens I ever bought. Probably about a year ago, I got my Canon 550D, my first ever digital SLR, and wow, it was just amazing. And I bought this lens at the same time for 400,000 South Korean won, which is about $400, I suppose. And yeah, I never looked back. I just used that lens for so much of my filmmaking and so much photography. I just use this all the time. It's just so beautiful. It captures such great images. And yeah, I really recommend for any beginning photographer to get this 50mm lens or the Canon 50mm 1.8 lens, which does a similar thing for, you know, a quarter of the price, but it isn't quite as nice quality as this. I'm glad I got this one. Yeah, this lens has just served me so well, and I don't really use it very much now because I have this, you know, I have this really nice fast standard zoom lens, which is image stabilized, unlike the 50mm there, but the 1.4 can pick up a lot of extra light when I'm filmmaking. So sometimes if I'm going outside into the night and I'm filmmaking, yeah, that thing's proven itself to be extremely useful. F1.4 is just really, really cool to work with, even though, you know, I love this lens too. And here we go, this is my last lens. Oh gosh, look at that giant lens head. There we go, Canon zoom lens, EF-S, 10-22mm. Yeah, fantastic. I love this lens. It's absolutely great. I don't find myself using it too much, because in South Korea, all the architecture is, well, it's beautiful, but it's very new. And I just use this super wide angle lens for architecture shots. I really love taking pictures of architecture. So when I go back to Wales in about 2 months, I'm going to crack this out and just get tons and tons of pictures of all the beautiful architecture there. Having a super wide angle lens, it's just awesome. It's really cool for filmmaking. You can walk around with it, and the effect is really cool. Yeah, it's a lot of fun to have this lens, and it's super high quality. Yeah, it cost me quite a bit of money, but cheaper than at home, that's for sure. So if I decide to sell it on, you know, I could probably make a little bit of a profit, actually. Yeah, I love this lens. Yeah, but once again, like I said, the lens I use the most is this standard zoom lens all the time. Gosh, what else have I got? Anything interesting? Here we go, a polarizing filter. Of course, very, very important. I never shoot outside without one of these. This is it's a Hoya extra thin circular polarizing filter. If you're shooting on digital, you need it to be a circular polarizing filter. As you can see from one of my videos, it basically makes the sky darker, which is pretty useful, and improves contrast and saturation in your pictures. So yeah, every time I'm outside, I try and put one of these on if it's light enough. This is 77mm. Which is the same size as the super wide angle, and the same size as my standard zoom lens. So that's really useful. I can just sort of change them over. It's pretty good. What else? What's that? Oh yeah, this is a little instruction manual for how to use the camera. Take care. That's all the warnings I put on. I lend my camera to people occasionally. Oh gosh, I wrote so much. Just look at this. I love talking. I love talking about cameras and stuff. Oh yes, look at all that. So I wrote that all for people, or for someone who's now my girlfriend, actually, so that they could use my camera effectively and, yeah, for easy shooting, for easy sound recording, all that stuff, without breaking my camera, because I want to lend my camera to people because it's nice, but only if they're super careful. Yeah, and that's about it, really. Here we go. Microfiber cleaning cloth. Of course, very, very important for lenses. Microfiber is just amazing. Every photographer, of course, should have one of those. What's this? Yes, you can't really see, but I have, of course, UV filters on all of this stuff. Let's see if I can get this lens head off. There we go. What kind is on there? Let's see. Made in Germany. Oh, that's my B&W filter. Extremely nice quality, but it's not UV, unfortunately. But yeah, gosh, that thing was really expensive, but it does a great job. I really find that, you know, anyone who wants to get a UV filter, well, good idea. You need one just to protect the front element of your lens. Gosh, you'd have to be crazy to have an expensive lens and not put a UV filter on the front of it, but it's essential to get a UV filter that's multi-coated. Ah, yes, look, can you see F-Pro? Oh no, it doesn't say, but you can take it from me, this is multi-coated, which means that it doesn't affect the picture quality so much. You still get nice contrast, you don't get extra flaring, like, let's see, what have I got here? In front of my main filter, I think it's a Hoya. Well, I know it's a Hoya. Yeah, there you go, Hoya HMC, multi-coated UV. You know, extremely useful just to protect your lens more than anything, but you must get multi-coated, not one of the cheap Canon filters. They're not multi-coated, and I've used a non-multi-coated one before, and it just introduces flare and gets rid of a lot of the nice contrast that the more expensive lenses give you. Definitely use multi-coated lenses. And yeah, gosh, I think that's about it. I have quite a nice mix of stuff. I don't have a nice telephoto lens at the moment. So I'm thinking of when I sell this, when I come into a bit more money, I might get a nice telephoto lens. But I don't really use telephoto focal lengths very much in my film work or in my photography. So I'm not too bothered about that. I'm extremely happy with what I have now. Yeah, it's all good. Ta-da, that's the end.